Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Getting ready to do a pet odor, we'll call it abatement. It's a treatment. This is what I recommend if you have pet odors. There's always somebody that wants to tell you they're gonna come out and they're gonna do what they call a subsurface extraction. And basically what that is they pour 5 gallons of whatever solution that they feel like is gonna do the trick, they pour it into the carpet, and then they put a water claw on it and they suck all that back out. Well, it doesn't really work even in theory. You obviously need to get more out if you take the pad out that's in question, you take it completely out and you put a new pad in, then, through deductive reasoning, the only thing left that you've got to deal with is the urine that's in the carpet itself. What's in the fibers you can generally fix, and then what's in the backing of the carpet, you've basically got to treat as well as you can, and hopefully you can make it go away. There's sometimes when this works, there's sometimes when this doesn't, but at any rate, you've taken the most pieces of the puzzle away and replaced them with new, so you're more likely to have good results with this. I've already pulled the carpet back. There was some furniture on it that we weren't gonna move, so I'm gonna have to make a seam, and a little bit of it will be through some carpet that was soaked with urine, so that's gonna smell really bad even when I get down here. But let me show you where I'm starting here. All right, here is the area in question. I didn't want to move that, and I don't blame him. I didn't want him to move that either. So I just made me a cut right here in front of it. And when I get done doing my pad replacement, I'll put this back together and I will treat those areas on the rug. And what I'm going to do to push for a faster dry time on this is I'm going to be mixing my odor counteractant with 91% alcohol. That way I can get it on there and get it dried much faster than if I were to just spray it. I don't like to reassemble the carpet when it's wet, so this way I'll have the peace of mind knowing that it's mostly dry by the time it goes back together, and that the 91% alcohol will carry the product into the backing of the carpet as deep as it needs to go and then quickly dry and leave it behind. So you can obviously tell where the problem, this is the carpet that I had to pick up at Home Depot. This is a $25 section of 6x9 pad that goes underneath a rug, and that's the easiest way to replace a small piece of padding. So that piece is going to go in here, basically where you see all of this right here. So there's one area that's here, and then this stuff is over here toward the wall. Looks like this piece, let's see. Yeah, if you mirror that out, this piece ought to be about right there. And this piece will be up from it just a little bit there. So basically right there, and right there. And I should be able to get most of it all covered with the pad. First thing, I'm gonna throw the pad over it and get as much coverage as I can. And then I'll cut and then put the pad in its place and take this old pad out. And then I will treat this and then I'll put it back together. So let me get to work on it and quit talking. And I'll be back with you when I've got something accomplished here.
All right, catch up to the video now.
This is my deodorizer mixed with alcohol and a little shot of water. So that's what I'm gonna be treating this with here in a minute. But I'll show you what I did here. The area that was in question, and I used up all the pad that I had. So that is what it's getting new, and it's not soaked into the concrete. So it's not. It could be worse. You know, I've certainly seen it when it was soaked into the concrete. And got the tech strip, and all in here, which they said over here was going to be the worst spot. And they were right, that's where most of it is. And urine has a lot of oil or fat in it. When somebody's leaning down, they're peeing out fat. So it's got fat in it, oil, lipids. So what we've got there is what we've got there. So the alcohol should make it penetrate faster and dry much faster, so I can hurry and put this back together. So I'm getting ready to treat it pretty well with that. I don't want to get it, I don't want to saturate it. So it's going to get a heck of a treatment and a little bit of dry time, hopefully without any true saturation. I don't want it to go through. I'm going to clean the carpet after this. And then while it's drying, I'm going to take all of this pad I got out and take it over to the dumpster, toss it in, and give it a little time to dry. Might even bring up a fan to hurry it along. But that's where we're at now in this little game I'm playing here with the urine. So anyway, I just wanted to catch up the video, and I'll be back in a bit whenever I've got some of those things accomplished that I just mentioned I'm gonna do. Strangest thing happened when I was spraying on. Keep in mind, this doesn't have any peroxide in it. If it had peroxide in it, it would make sense why it's doing this. But basically, as I sprayed it on, it kind of bleached the color out of the urine. So waiting for this to dry, it should maintain, because of the fat in it, or the oil rather, it should maintain kind of a wet look after it's dry, completely dry here. And I was amazed because it looked like I was spraying peroxide on it, the way it was making the urine basically kind of go away. At some point I'll tell you exactly what I use for an odor counteractant, but it's nothing that comes from a carpet supply store, though. That part I can guarantee you. Anyway, I'm gonna go haul off some pad, and we'll come back and have a look at this and see how it's drying. Shouldn't take real long. It's only got a little bit of water in it, and the rest is alcohol, so anyway, I'll be back. Dry. I'm going to give it a few more minutes and then I'm going to put it back together. It's certainly dry enough for it to be seamed. Alright, next step here is to seam this guy back together. And you can tell it's in need of stretching. It's I was worried about making it reach, but it's actually too close. I've got to try to, when I seam it, make it all go flat again. It's in a bit of a wrinkle. Anyway, the irons are just about ready to go. So I'm gonna seam it back together, and then I'm gonna tuck everything in here, and then we'll switch videos, and I'm gonna clean some carpet. I don't know exactly what areas I'm gonna clean, and I don't know what the furniture placement's gonna be, but I gotta figure all that out before I begin. All right, I'm gonna get the seaming here. I think all three irons are ready to go now. So here we go. And over there is gonna smell bad because I'm gonna see him through where the urine's at. So anyway, here we go. Back in place now. It's in need of stretching actually, but I got it all seamed back together real well, and the heat made it lay flat, but it was trying to bubble up there where I was seaming. But we are good here. Now we're gonna do some cleaning here next. Put up my toys here.
get ready to clean now. I give the option of cleaning. He wanted to get the rug done and he wanted it to be done this afternoon. I recommended doing the room and not the rug, but he wanted to do the rug in place like this. So that's what we're gonna do. Mainly the area was over there. So at any rate, we're better than we were when we started. Anyway, I'm gonna clean all of this here and I'm gonna use my new microfiber star patterned bonnets on this one. Everything over here, I've misted with peroxide after I treated it. So anyway, I'm gonna run the machine over it and we'll take a look here in a little bit when I'm done.
We had concrete floors in our last house and we sort of needed a puddle to sit the furniture on. So
uh-huh.
It created a, defined the space. So we even got that thing custom made and custom dyed.
This is purple.
Nice, isn't it? Took place on BP. Some ABC carpet in the home?
Uh-huh. I don't know if they're around anymore.
Are they?
I'm not sure. All right, guys, we are done. I am headed home. Finished up this gentleman, and I'm going to come back next week, I believe Tuesday, and do the rest of the house. Him and his wife wanted to get back to relaxing, and I don't blame him. What was funny was I hear this every once in a while, fairly often, actually. He goes, I'm not telling you how you should run your business, but you don't charge near enough for the level of service that you give. And I've heard that before. And it makes you feel good because people realize that you take your job serious. And I have considered raising prices several times, but and now that the economy just tanked again, I just can't justify doing it right now, so I'm not gonna do it yet again. But it sure makes you feel good when you hear somebody tell you that. You know, had a girl I was gonna go out and do a job for this morning, and you know, today's the 23rd. I set the job up last week, and you know, so I set her up for the 23rd, and today's the 23rd. I said, all right, well, I'll be there, at an hour and a half or so. And she goes, no, I'm not ready. I thought you meant May 23rd, you know. And, you know, she had asked, you know, if I could possibly do the work cheaper because, you know, she's in financial issues, you know, disabled. So I told her I would take care of it for free. And I just... You know, I like to help people, but at the same time, you know, I allotted a certain amount of time to help her, and she sent me there, and I didn't have anything to do this morning. I could have put somebody in that time slot. So, you know, I already know how to feel about that, you know. You want to help people, and a lot of times, you know, I'll surprise them, you know, at the end of the job, and, you know, if I know they're in financial dire straits, you know, and I'll let them know that, you know, this one's on me. So, at any rate, you know, you meet all kinds of different people, you know, you're in and out of everybody's house, and, you know, and you're a guest, and some people make wonderful hosts, some people don't. You know, basically what I'm looking for at the end of the day is a really good experience. You know, I'm there to do a really good job, and I'm damn good at what I do, and I take it very serious. But at the end of the day, what I'm looking for is a good experience, and it's not so much about the money I make. I mean, I'm working when other guys are not, and I have raised the prices throughout the years. It's weird how some people will act like you're trying to rob them when they're pricing you, and other people, you know, will tip. I think the record tip I've ever had was like $160 tip was the record tip that I've gotten in all these years. You know, but it's not common or not uncommon to get, you know, a $40 to $60 tip, you know, and people appreciate what you do. Anyway, I'm in traffic here, heading home. I'm gonna get home and upload the video. Thanks for watching and God bless.